Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Philadelphia Chamber Music Society. On behalf of our founding artistic director, Tony Cecchia, and our executive director, Philip Manivel, my name is Miles. I'm the artistic director. We're so pleased to have you here joining us virtually for these three fantastic musicians in Hsin-Yun Huang, Misha Amory, and Tom Sauer. We'll turn things over to them in just a few minutes. Before then, a few announcements to get through. The first announcement is we hope that all of you had a happy and a healthy holiday season. We miss seeing you very much, but we're excited for the beginning of the 2021 portion of our season. And to start it off, we're highlighting an instrument that often doesn't get a spotlight, and that is the viola, with two outstanding violists in Hsin-Yun and Misha. And they've crafted a program that we really feel you're going to love this evening. Now, before we do turn things over to them, let's get through a few announcements. The first announcement is that if you're joining us for the first time, welcome to the Philadelphia Chamber Music Society, and welcome to PCMS, as we say informally. This is the home hall of the Philosophical Society. It's called Benjamin Franklin Hall. In a normal season, we would have about a third of our season here, and we would perform to a packed house. We are not in a normal season, so we are doing all of our concerts here because our other venues are not available to us. And there's nobody in the hall as we follow the protocol of the City Health Department of Philadelphia. There's just the staff and our musicians that'll join us in a few minutes. As you watch this evening from one of our three platforms, you may be watching from our website, our YouTube page, or Facebook. Please know that we have a live chat function that is there for you. We have a trio of staff members in Michelle Shirk, Brian Potter, and Marina Weber, and they're all here to answer your questions or your comments about the program or the musicians, anything that comes to your mind. They would love to start a dialogue with you. Also note, as we did this fall, we'll continue to do into the winter portion and spring portion of our season, and we'll run the broadcast after this initial performance tonight for 72 hours. So if you'd like to hear it again, watch it again, or you want to tell a friend, by all means, pass along that this concert is available for another 3 days. And last but not least, as we discussed, the stage portion of Benjamin Franklin Hall is a mask optional zone, and we've done that to give our artists maximum freedom when it comes to what they feel most comfortable doing performing. We'll see tonight that two of our artists will perform without a mask and one will perform with a mask. So whatever they feel most comfortable with, that's what we would like to offer to them. But everywhere else in the hall, backstage, and in the house, everyone else is wearing a mask at all times. Let's talk a little bit about support and highlight a few people, and then we'll turn it over to the three musicians that are featured tonight in our performance. Many of you joined us throughout our break when we had a whole week of rebroadcasts of our 13 fall concerts. And on behalf of Philip and the staff and the board of directors, we all want to say a huge thank you to those of you that joined us. Not only did you participate again in watching performances, you also gave generously. And we couldn't be more grateful for that support. It helped us end the year on a very high note. Now, we've turned the page to a new year, but even though we've done that, we still need your support. We haven't gotten to January and everything is solved. We still need your support for two main reasons. Number one, it really does look like for much of the season we will not be able to have an audience, or a very small audience, if at that. And so we have no box office income coming in. And the other thing that's most important to us, and I think it's important to you as well, is that we've continued throughout the pandemic, and we will continue to pay our artists their originally negotiated fee, to pay the hall and the piano tuners their rent and their fee, and to pay our staff just like we would in normal times without any pay reduction. So the only way we can continue to do that, sincerely, is through your generosity. As you watch tonight on our website or on our Facebook page, you will notice below the video section, you will notice a donation section. And there are categories there. I call your attention to the $25 category because that would be the amount you would pay if you were sitting in the hall this evening watching this performance. Again, whether you give $5 or $25 or more, whether you just want to watch, either way, we're so happy that you're here and you're joining us. We thank three sets of people, specifically Dr. Susan Giesecke Bloom and Dr. A. Charles Winkelman. We thank them in the fall. We'll thank them again. They were really instrumental in helping us to raise money to upgrade our live stream equipment. Two people here at the Philosophical Society need to be highlighted, and that's for their unwavering support of PCMS concerts. That's Robert Hauser, the executive officer, and Annie Westcott, director of meetings. And of course, we want to highlight and say thank you, a big thank you, to our audio and video engineers. That's Noriko Okabe on video, excuse me, on audio. I knew I'd blow that at one point. And Matt Genders on video. We also say hi to Jody Lee, our production manager. He's working a camera up there. And everybody is being led here at Philosophical Society by our very, very special colleague, Eric Peterson's. A huge thank you to all of them. Ladies and gentlemen, we do wish that you were here with us tonight, but we're so thrilled that you're able to join us virtually. Please help me now welcome to the stage Hsin-Yun Huang and Misha Amory. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Berio wrote a set of these miniatures for two violins in the 70s and 80s, and they're an obvious homage to the two violin duos, the 44 duos for two violins that Bartok composed. And in the case of Berio, he did something kind of charming, which is he dedicated each little miniature piece to somebody he knew, a friend, an associate, a loved one, someone who he considered a strong influence on him. And these miniatures are not so much descriptions or portraits of the people they're dedicated to, but often they could be that, or they could be an association that Berio had with that person, a situation that he remembers that he shared with that person, or a way in which that person had an impact on the composer. So I'll briefly read out the title of each of these little miniature duets, which is the name of the dedicatee and just sort of what he or she did. So the first one is dedicated to Fiamma Nicolodi, who was a musicologist. Neuberger, who was a friend of Berio's and his agent in France. Giorgio Federico Ghedini, who was a composer and a conductor and was Berio's teacher in Milan. Thank you. Alfred Schley, who was a publisher, music publisher at Universal. Lele D'Amico, who was a music critic. Thank you. Bruno Maderna composer. Finally, Aldo Benici, violist.